Hey there, how's it going?
Hi.
Me? I'm super tired, jet lag. Just got off the red eye from Paris.
Oh, Paris.
Yeah, I was over there seeing the Chapel of Miracles. Super sick. Mm-hmm. And then I hopped on a private jet and went to Lourdes, met with a bishop, you know, VIP status. Reminds me of when I was in Rome last year. So I got personal access to St. Peter's chalice collection, you know? And then for lunch, I got lunch with not one, but two dose cardinals. And for dinner, we went to the super exclusive Numerian apparition site. You gotta know someone who knows someone, you know what I mean?
Can I ask, what did you learn from this?
What?
Like, what did you gain from it spiritually?
That I'm a pretty big deal in the eyes of the Lord. Hey, where are you going? You didn't give me your number yet. Hi, I'm Nick.
And I'm Gabby. Welcome to Catholic Central.
Pilgrims.
The reason why, until recently, you couldn't buy alcohol on Sunday in Massachusetts.
Sure. But pilgrims are also me, you, all of us.
And luckily, no frilly bonnets are required. It is a good idea, though, to dress modestly, because Catholic pilgrimages are special trips to holy places.
Oh, yeah. So I tried to wear a Van Halen t-shirt into St. Peter's Basilica. It did not go over well.
No, I cannot imagine that would. Making pilgrimages is a centuries-old tradition for Catholics.
Okay, that's great, guys. But I need to know what airline has the best food, which hotels have dog spas, and where I can get a 360-minute red clay and diamond shavings massage. Oh, and also, do we know what the Wi-Fi switch in Jerusalem is?
Hold on a second. Pilgrimages aren't just excuses to use all your miles, max out your credit cards, and try to get your Instagram followers in the thousands. In fact, they require a whole different mentality.
Pilgrimages are not the same as tourism. In a sense, they externalize the inward path to God. Even though the pilgrimages are usually centered around holy objects or sites, they're always more about the faith experience.
That doesn't mean you can't eat your body weight in pasta, because trust me, I cleaned out several trattorias. But the main focus should be on deepening your faith and being open to whatever God has for you.
Which sometimes involves sacrificing the comfort and convenience that we're used to and offering that up to God.
So let's start with the number one reason for pilgrimage: holy sites and relics. Catholics love visiting places where major things happened.
And seeing the bones and body parts of saints, which we call relics. Relics can also be things that the saints owned, or even things that touched a saint's remains. Now, you might think this is gross and macabre.
Or that it's the most metal thing ever.
But both perspectives kind of miss the point.
Relics are tangible, physical reminders that saints were human beings, and that holiness is achievable, even for people like us.
Even though I'd personally rather not end up scattered into 1,000 pieces. Thank you.
Now, Catholics don't worship relics, but venerate them as a way to honor the God that created them, who they served.
And feel closer to holy people who we consider to be our friends in heaven.
Especially the ones that are incorrupt, meaning that they haven't decayed like they should.
Incorrupt bodies are on a spectrum, from just looking like they fell asleep
to slightly short of zombie.
Whoa. To give Catherine of Siena some credit, she was born in 1347 and still looks fantastic.
Technically, she should be feeding the flowers at this point.
And if you're still feeling grossed out, keep in mind relics are not required viewing.
If you want to, though, two of the best places for this kind of pilgrimage are the Holy Land, where Jesus was born, where he ministered and died.
And Nick's favorite place, Rome.
Oh, Roma. Excellent carbonara, gelato, tiramisu, panini, così buono. Even the McDonald's is better there. Oh, fantastica.
Okay, we get it. You went to Rome. Also, apparently, I hear there's a saint on every corner.
Yeah. Another big draw for Catholic pilgrims are places where the church has affirmed an appearance by Mary, the mother of Jesus.
And these aren't just anyone who found a particularly Mary-looking Cheeto yesterday afternoon.
The Catholic Church is a process of investigation that leads us to be able to say that certain apparitions or appearances are worthy of belief.
Meaning it seems authentically supernatural and not something someone made up because they wanted to add an in-ground pool.
Some of the bigger apparition sites include Mexico City, Mexico, Fatima, Portugal, and Lourdes, France.
Lourdes became a holy site when the Virgin Mary appeared to a young girl named Bernadette Soubirous in 1858.
In Bernadette's dialect of French, Mary announced that she was the Immaculate Conception.
Something that had only been officially declared a few years before, and which Bernadette didn't know anything about.
Mary told Bernadette that she wanted a chapel built at the site and instructed her to dig the soil.
A stream appeared, which now provides 27,000 gallons of water every day for pilgrims to bathe in.
The baths have generated many healings that have been scientifically verified by secular doctors as having no scientific explanation for the healing.
Lourdes also offers an extremely tacky selection of glow-in-the-dark Mary statues and religious artifacts covered in sparkle.
You know, if you're looking for some Catholic bling.
Okay, once again, not the point.
Just like how relics are not required viewing, however, it's not required to believe in Marian apparitions.
But they can be a reminder that to Catholics, miracles and the supernatural are just part of ordinary life.
Catholics see Marian apparitions as a mother checking in on us, instructing us, and showing us her love.
And sights of Marian apparitions can help us grow in a relationship with her.
The third kind of Catholic pilgrimage is a walked pilgrimage.
Or as I like to call it, getting dragged by your friends to spend 10 hours a day getting blisters and sunburned. The best known of these is the Way of St. James, or the Camino de Santiago.
The town of Santiago de Compostela became known as a holy site because the Apostle James the Great is buried there.
During the 9th century, pilgrims began walking to Santiago de Compostela from all parts of Europe, and it was meant as a way to take away purgatory time for the faithful Christians who completed the last 100 kilometers of the journey.
Which I'd say they really earned since they didn't even have Spotify.
Or headphones. The Camino today remains popular for people seeking a meditative hike through northern Spain that will challenge you and grow your faith.
The next kind of pilgrimage is Catholic Ragers. And by that I mean giant group gatherings where we sing praise and worship music.
And World Youth Day is one such gathering that takes place every 2 to 3 years in a different city around the world.
Its target audience is people aged 18 to 35.
But they won't kick you out if you're less of a youth and more of a wise elder.
It can draw millions of people, and the Pope usually attends as well. It's a great event for meeting Catholics from other countries and sharing your faith.
Now, if you're thinking, well, this is all great, but you're giving us champagne tips and I'm on a sparkling water budget, you're in luck. Because there are many sites around the world that are considered places of pilgrimage.
Either because of relics or special history or the church's theme for the year.
Those pilgrimages are just as valid as long as you approach them with the same reverence, humility, and openness to God.
Let us know in the comments below where you've been and where you want to go. Roma. For Catholic Central, I'm Nick.
And I'm Gabby.
Roma.
Always with the Roma.
I know, I love Roma.